JPA and Hibernate provide a default mapping that maps each entity class to a database table with the same name. Each of its attributes gets mapped to a column with the same name. But what if you want to change this default, for example, because it doesn't match your company's naming conventions? Hi, I'm Torben Janssen, and today I will show you how to use Hibernate's naming strategies to adjust your table and column mappings. If you're new here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring, and all types of other Java persistence-related stuff, subscribe and click the bell so you don't miss anything. You can, of course, specify the table name for each entity and the column name for each attribute. That requires a table annotation on each class and a column annotation on each attribute. This is called an explicit naming. That's a good approach if you want to change the mapping for one attribute. But doing that for lots of attributes requires a lot of work. Adapting Hibernate's naming strategy is then often a better approach. In this video, I will show you how to use it to adjust the mapping of all entities and attributes. But before we do that, we first need to talk about the difference between Hibernate's logical and physical naming strategy. Let's get started. Hibernate splits the mapping of the entity or attribute name to the table or column name into two steps. It first determines the logical name of an entity or attribute. You can explicitly set the logical name using the table and column annotations. If you don't do that, Hibernate will use one of its implicit naming strategies. It then maps the logical name to a physical name. By default, Hibernate uses the logical name as the physical name, but you can also use a physical naming strategy that maps the logical name to a physical one that follows your internal naming convention. So, why does Hibernate differentiate between a logical and a physical naming strategy, but the JPA specification doesn't? JPA's approach works, but if you take a closer look at it, you recognize that Hibernate's approach provides more flexibility. By splitting the process into two steps, Hibernate allows you to implement a conversion that gets applied to all attributes and classes. If your naming conventions, for example, require you to add underscore TBL to all table names, you can do that in your physical naming strategy. It then doesn't matter if you explicitly specify the table name in a table annotation or if you do it implicitly based on the entity name. In both cases, Hibernate will add underscore TBL to the end of your table name. Because of the added flexibility, I like Hibernate's approach a little better. As explained earlier, you can either define the logical name explicitly or implicitly. Let's take a look at both options. The explicit naming strategy is very easy to use. You probably already used it yourself. The only thing you need to do is to annotate your entity class with a table annotation or your entity attribute with a column annotation and provide your preferred name as a value to the name attribute. If you then use this entity in your code and activate the logging of SQL statements, you can see that Hibernate uses the provided names instead of the default ones. If you don't set the table or column name in an annotation, Hibernate uses one of its implicit naming strategies. You can choose between four different naming strategies and one default strategy. By default, Hibernate uses the implicit naming strategy defined by the JPA specification. This value is an alias for JPA. This is the naming strategy defined by the JPA 2.0 specification. The logical name of an entity class is either the name provided in the entity annotation or the unqualified class name. For basic attributes, it uses the name of the attributes as the logical name. To get the logical name of a join column of an association, this strategy concatenates the name of the referencing attribute, an underscore, and the name of the primary key attribute of the referenced entity. The logical name of a join column of an element collection consists of the name of the entity that owns the association, an underscore, and the name of the primary key attribute of the reference entity. And the logical name of a join table starts with the physical name of the owning table followed by an underscore and the physical name of the referencing table. This is Hibernate's original naming strategy. It doesn't recognize any of JPA's annotations, but you can use Hibernate's proprietary configuration file and annotations to define a column or entity name. In addition to that, there are a few other differences to the JPA specification. The logical name of a join column is only its attribute name. For join tables, this strategy concatenates the name of the physical table that owns the association, an underscore, and the name of the attribute that owns the association. The legacy JPA strategy implements the naming strategy defined by JPA 1.0. The main differences to the JPA strategy are the logical name of a join table consists of the physical table name of the owning side of the association, an underscore, and either the physical name of the referencing side of the association or the owning attribute of the association. To get the logical name of the join column of an element collection, the legacy JPA strategy uses the physical table name instead of the entity name of the reference side of the association. That means the logical name of the join column consists of the physical table name of the reference side of the association, an underscore, and the name of the referenced primary key column. This strategy is almost identical to the JPA strategy. The only difference is that it includes the name of the composite in the logical attribute name. You can configure the logical naming strategy by setting the hibernate.implicit naming strategy attribute in your configuration. Implementing your own physical naming strategy isn't complicated. You can either implement the physical naming strategy interface or extend Hibernate's physical naming strategy standard impl class. I prefer extending Hibernate's physical naming strategy standard impl. In the following example, you create a naming strategy that adds the postfix underscore tbl to each table name and to create a naming strategy that converts camel case names into snake case. The only thing I want to change in this naming strategy is the handling of the table name. So extending Hibernate's physical naming strategy standard impl class is the easiest way to achieve that. I override the toPhysicalTableName method, add a static postfix to the name, and convert it into an identifier. In the next step, you need to activate the naming strategy. You do that by setting the Hibernate.PhysicalNamingStrategy attribute to the fully qualified class name of the strategy. Let's try this mapping using this basic author entity. I don't specify a logical name for the entity. So it defaults to the name of the class, which is author. Without our custom naming strategy, Hibernate would map this entity to the author table. When I persist this entity, you can see in the log file that Hibernate mapped it to the author underscore tbl table. In Java, we prefer to use camel case for our class and attribute names. By default, Hibernate uses the logical name as the physical name, so the entity attribute publishing date gets mapped to the database column publishing date. Some companies use naming conventions that require you to use snake case for your table and column names. That means that your publishing date attribute needs to be mapped to the publishing underscore date column. As explained earlier, you could use the explicit naming strategy and annotate each attribute with a column annotation. But for most persistence layers, that's a lot of work and it's easy to forget. So let's implement a naming strategy that does that for us. The interesting part of this naming strategy is the toSnakeCase method. I call it in all methods that return a physical name to convert the provided name to snakeCase. If you're familiar with regular expressions, the implementation of the toSnakeCase method is pretty simple. By calling this replaceAll method, we add an underscore in front of each capital letter. After that is done, we only need to change all characters to lowercase. In the next step, we need to set the strategy in the persistence.xml file. When I now persist this book entity, Hibernate will use the custom strategy to map the publishing date attribute to the database column publishing underscore date. As you can see in the log file, the naming strategy worked as expected, and change the name of the publishing date column to publishing underscore date. Hibernate's naming strategy provides you with lots of flexibility. It consists of two parts, the mapping of the logical and the physical name. You can explicitly define the logical name using the table and column annotation. If you don't do that, Hibernate uses one of its implicit naming strategies. The default one is compliant with JPA 2.0. After the logical name got determined, Hibernate applies a physical naming strategy. By default, it returns the logical name. But you can use it to implement a conversion that gets applied to all logical names. As you have seen in the examples, this provides an easy way to fulfill your internal naming conventions. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join my free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video, and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!